All right, well, going into the 2014 season, I had a lot of nerves about it, kind of antsy. Most people are really excited about it, getting ready. But the way I ended 2013 archery was on a terrible, terrible miss. I had a doe probably 22 yards and just skied her. I'm talking about missed her by a foot. It was almost one of those times where you just want to jump out of the tree stand, get your air, and leave. I think shortly after that I did leave. So that's how I ended 2013. Picked up the gun, continued on. So I shot a bunch through the summer to try to get my confidence back. Got with different people and shot by myself, put in a lot of hours, a lot of shots. So my confidence was pretty high going in, but I still wanted to get a doe down day one, get it out the way, and that's exactly what happened on day one. Find the deer, and I feel amazing because it's, you know, what I've been looking forward to. I got a deer down. I made a great shot. I feel like my confidence is where it should be right now for later in the season when that big daddy steps out so I can lay him down. Shot feels.
So for the past 3 years, I've been on this journey to kill a good deer with my bow. And the best thing I have to show for it is this little bitty 4-point.
At the end of my 2013 season, I had put in over 300 hours in the stand and had only seen one shooter. So going into 2014, I decided I was going to work really, really hard to do whatever I had to do to get a shooter within bow range. Last year, during the first cold snap in October, is when I saw my shooter. I probably saw 11 deer that morning. I was sitting over these soybeans, actually. And he was the last deer out in the field. He only got within 63 yards. I wasn't really comfortable with that shot, so I let him walk. So this year, when the weather predicted that the first cold snap was going to be the third, I was super excited to get in the stand and to see what was going to happen.
Well, it's October 3rd, the evening of. It's about 5 o'clock. This is my first time to ever self-film. And for some reason, I picked the stand that's about a mile into the woods. Terrible decision. I'm sitting in an oak bottom, dropping a lot of acorns right now. Got a bedded thicket about 100 yards in front of me, and a thicket that's about 50 yards behind me. And this is just a travel corridor where they come through. I've got standing soybeans about 200 yards that way. I've also got standing soybeans about 200 yards that way. So it should be a good afternoon. We've got a front coming in tonight, so maybe the deer will move before that front comes in. I'm looking forward to this hunt. This is my first time self-filming, and it would be really awesome if I could get a shooter deer down, first time to ever self-film. We'll keep you updated, Mississippi Mud.
So at about 9:30 that morning, I had seen plenty of deer. All of them were does except one little buck, and the wind started swirling on me, so I decided to get down. I didn't want to ruin that good spot, so I've unplugged the mic from my camera, turn around to take my bow off the hanger, and there are two bucks within 15 yards of me, and one of them is a deer we call Andre, and he was on our hit list. So once I get my bow off the hanger, I put my camera in my shooting lane, hit record, and come to full draw. Unfortunately, he does not cooperate. And he wins me, he turns around, and he's starting to head out. I was at full draw. Did not think I had the time to get back, get my camera on him, and take a shot. So I took the shot I had. I turned my camera around and the audio's off and I don't even know it. And I'm saying something like, I just shot the biggest buck of my life. I feel good about the shot, the standard stuff. But I was trying to be cool for the camera, but I was literally about to pass out or about to fall out of the tree one. I shot him at 17 yards. I felt really, really good about that. Called a buddy of mine. He came over to help me look for it. We found blood at the point of contact. That was it. And it took us probably 45 minutes to an hour to even find the next blood. And we just basically made a big loop and found the trail. And there was a lot of blood. Incredible blood trail, and all the way till we found the arrow, and then the blood just stopped. And at that point, we've been trailing him for about 3 hours. And so we made one big loop from where we last saw blood, and then at that point, we just gave up, and all that hard work seemed like it was down the drain. I was really, really down. That is until we called for backup. I mean, incredible start to the 2014 season. My second time ever self-filming, second time out with a bow this year, and have a hitless buck on the ground. That's an incredible feeling. I really, really can't wait to see what else we can do for the rest of the season. 2014 season. I mean, I've already got the biggest buck on the ground in my entire life. It's only the second day. I seriously just had a bug going in my ear. Seriously. Well, that's the Mississippi. Mm-hmm.